Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is 4 3-minute rounds in the light heavyweight division. Introducing first, boxing out of your blue corner. He wears the red and white shorts. He weighed in at 12 stone, 5 pounds and 2 ounces. Tonight, he's taking part in his 110th professional contest. From Lydney, Gloucestershire, Lewis Van Potch Poochie. And opposing him across the ring, boxing out of your red corner. He wears the silver, green and red shorts. He weighed in at 11 stone, 8 pounds and 14 ounces. He brings an undefeated professional record, 5 wins and 1 draw. 1 win coming inside the distance. From Middleton, Alan Michael Jr. 4 3-minute rounds. Your referee, Darren Sargentson. Your timekeeper, Chris O'Connor.
Right, everybody, welcome back. We're at Oldham Leisure Centre, as you know, for the Black Flash promotion show in association with BBTV. We hope you're enjoying the show. I'm Aki Kareem. I'm joined by Dan Murray.
I was going to say it's an interesting combat fight, this, for Aaron, because Van Pooch can fight. He's a great entertainer, but he can fight as well.
He really can fight. Last time I seen him out, he was against Anton Wright. In fact, you were there, Dan.
I was there, yeah.
At Earlham and Cadishaw Leisure Centre. Really good fight.
Yeah, he knows his way around the ring.
Lovely.
And so does Aaron. Aaron's, he's one of those guys. He's quite tall. He's rangy. He's got a good jab.
Yeah.
Does everything technically well.
He started very well. He, like you say, he's got a nice sharp jab, and I think that's going to be the key tonight. We need to get that jab off. I don't think he wants to trade with Van Pooch.
No, it's very difficult to stop Pooch as well.
Yeah.
He has been in there up and down the country with everyone. If he does see an opening, he will take it.
Yeah. He looks
right
very
hand over
sharp,
the top.
Doesn't he, Aaron?
Yeah, nice right hand over the top there. Kind of caught him sort of temple around the ear. They're the sort of shots that discombobulate you, aren't they?
Yeah, they can disorientate you. I think Aaron needs a disciplined performance here. He just needs to work that jab, get his combinations off and get his feet out and move. He don't want to stand there with Van Pooch because, like you said, if Van Pooch sees an opening, he will take it. I think it'd be good just for Aaron just to get back in the ring after his time out, get his timing back.
Good stabbing body shot there from Pucci.
Yeah, it's an underrated shot, the body shot, the jab to the body there. You can just take a little bit out of your opponent, especially in the longer fights.
You've got to throw it properly, haven't you? You've got to throw it really short and stabbing and get out of range quickly, though, haven't you?
Yeah, it's a dangerous shot because when you jab into the body, you can leave yourself open to a headshot. So you've really got to kind of think about it. You've got to bend your knees, you've got to be nice and compact, and you've got to, like you say, a nice short stab.
Good little combination, just as his back touched the ropes there, Aaron.
Yeah, the problem is when Aaron's throwing them, it's landing the gloves of Van Pooch. So what I'd like to see is work behind that jab and just pick your shots a little bit more, rather than just throwing them for the sake of throwing them.
Now, an interesting dynamic here. Poochie's the one that seems to be trying to cut the ring off on Aaron and walking him down.
Yeah, he comes to fight and he's maybe seen something that he likes, so he's going to have a go tonight, maybe.
Anyone just tuning in, we're at Oldham Leisure Centre tonight. Streaming the show live on British Boxers' Facebook page. And thanks to all of you who've shared the link. Much appreciated.
Oh. I think the thing for Aaron here, I think there'll be a lot of nerves as well. It's his first fight back. There'll be a lot of nerves and he'll be kind of just settling into the fight. And I think Pat would just want him to get him back to the corner in between the rounds and settle him down a bit and give him some advice for the second round. But I think so far so good for Aaron. It's been a good competitive first round, but so far so good.
Interesting first round there, Dan. How are you actually scoring the first round then?
I would probably give it to Aaron. I thought Aaron was a bit better earlier on, but it was a close round. It's a tough round as well. It's a solid first fight back for Aaron, this, and he'll have to really work for the victory. But Pat knows what he's doing. Pat's obviously matched him a bit difficult here, and he thinks he'll bring the best out in Aaron, and I'm sure it will.
It's probably better to match fighters a bit more with the difficult guys, though, isn't it? Because the last thing you really need or learn from. It's coming in, banging someone out in the first 5 seconds. I mean, you don't really learn much from that, do you? And padding your record out in that fashion.
It depends on the fighter. I mean, when a fighter's at a layoff, some fighters will need a couple of confidence boosters, and that's okay to give them one or two to get back into it. But Pat obviously knows his fighter very well, and he thinks that Aaron probably needs a step-up in opponent, needs someone who's going to come and win and come to fight. And that's what he's got here in Van Pooch.
He's a Middleton lad, is Aaron. A lot of Middleton lads on the show tonight.
Yeah. See, Aaron's come up, back out now, and he's working that jab a lot, and I think that's the key to the fight. But he's also got to mix that jab up with a few feints. Don't become predictable with it. Sometimes double it. Because you can hear the corner there, Van Pooch. They're asking him to slip the jab. So it's very important for Aaron not to become predictable with it.
Yeah, and also he's throwing the jab a lot on the back foot as well, so he's not getting much power in the jab, is he? It's more of a range finder, keeping him off, sort of keeping him busy sort of jab, isn't it?
Yeah, I think he's probably a little concerned with if you jab and stay in range with Van Pooch, he'll counter you. So he's just trying to kind of get himself out of range. But what you can do as well is you can jab and you can step towards your fighter, you can smother the distance as well to stop the counters. And you can see that Aaron done that sort of unintentionally there, he jabbed and kind of closed the distance.
One thing Pooch is very good at is counter-punching.
Yeah.
So in some ways, you know, being on the back foot and just sort of moving around and using your movement and variation might not be a bad tactic against him.
No, you said earlier not many people are going to stop Van Pooch, and I'm not sure Aaron's capable of doing it. So I think the most important thing is to get the victory. And just box, don't take no silly chances. Box, get the round and he gets a victory. That's what you're looking to do. You're not looking to trade with him. So then he's done his work, so then move out of range, kind of compose yourself, set yourself and get back on that jab.
5 minutes.
You can see in the second round Aaron's a lot more composed, he's a lot more settled, and he's really thinking about his work now, and it's paying off for him. I think it's a lot more comfortable this second round for him.
Yeah, it's not like an all action, all guns blazing fight, but we've seen a lot of technical work in there from Aaron. And that was a lovely counter, little counter uppercut there, really nice shot, picked it beautifully, and Pucci gave him a little nod. Yeah. And for the boxing connoisseur, you'll have liked that shot, because he sort of brought Pucci onto the shot and countered nicely.
I'm actually enjoying the second round from Aaron. He's really kind of getting into it now, he's getting his rhythm a bit. Don't want to see him sit on the ropes like that though, I want to see him keep changing the angle, keep moving about, and don't let Pucci set himself for the shots.
But yeah, considering he's been out of the ring so long, he looks quite sharp, and it's that distance measurement. You know, when you come back after a long time, it's that range finding. He seems to be measuring that distance nicely, especially getting out of the way of shots.
Yeah, that's a very good second round. I imagine Pat's going to be a lot more happy with that round. And he looks very composed. He's breathing nice and steady on the stool, and that he looks calm. It's a good round that. I mean, in a fight like this, Aki, I'm always quite cautious. I want the fighter to get the victory first. I don't really want him to take many chances in that. But what about you? Would you like to see Aaron step it up? Or do you think, similar to me, in that it's victory first?
Well, knowing the opponent in Pucci,
yeah,
I would advise to stick with these particular tactics.
Yeah.
But in general, I do like the come forward, the locking type fighters.
Yeah.
And, you know, but it's just one of them. You've got to measure the opponent in front of you, haven't you?
Yeah.
So, against Pucci, probably not the best of tactics. Now, Anton Wright in his professional debut had a great professional debut, and he made it a really exciting fight because he did try and come on the front foot against Pucci, which is why they were exchanging a lot of shots. But if Aaron can win the rounds like this, then yeah, I agree with you, and the win comes first.
Yeah. I imagine Pat's got him boxed into a plan, and that's part of it as well. That's part of the learning kind of curve of a fighter coming up. Not just going in and blasting your fighters out. Can you follow a plan if you've got that discipline? And he looks like he's following a plan here. I think in this round it looks like Van Pooch has come out. He's going to try and maybe force the action a little bit more. He probably felt that second round got away from him a little bit, and this third round he's looking to kind of close the distance, I feel, and he's going to try and put the pressure on.
And Pooch is going for it now. He's went for a Hail Mary there.
Yeah, this is where Aaron's got to be very, very switched on. Aaron switches southpaw a lot, but when he switches southpaw, he doesn't actually throw any shots.
Pooch, you're looking for that right hand over the top, isn't he?
Yeah. And that's why Aaron's got to be switched on. Switched on at all times.
He's seen that left hand being dropped. I know a lot of these people like to, a lot of the fighters like to do that Felicia type style defence, but you've got to get the timing right for it. And you are open for the right hand over the top with that Felicia.
Yeah, it's okay dropping your left hand if you're fully aware of what shots are going to be coming back to you.
Oh, caught him with the left hook
there.
I told you the left hook.
And Gary Thornhill in the corner telling him, I told you about the left hook. And Gary Thornhill himself was a devastating left hook puncher. You know, won the British title using that left hook. But yeah, Pooch landed a right hook there around the corner, which may just have stunned him a little bit.
Stay on him.
Pucci's staying on him, and I think Aaron's legs might have gone a little bit here,
he's on shaky legs. I'd like to see him tie Van Pooch up now, show a bit of experience, tie him up, spoil it.
I think he looks a bit dazed here, Dan.
He is.
I think Pucci can sniff blood here.
Yeah, he is dazed. He needs to really kind of hold on now.
He still looks a little bit shaky, Dan, on them legs, and Pucci's going for that. That's a good left hook there from Pucci. And Aaron's done well to stay up there, but he does look dazed.
The end does look near here. I would just like to see Aaron hold on, try and spoil it, but his legs look gone, he looks quite hurt.
Pucci winging in them hooks, and a good short right hook on the inside there. And Aaron doing very well to take these shots, but we don't want to see him take too many of these shots.
No, it's quite concerning this for Aaron.
I don't like the way he's moving now at the minute. Oh, that's another one as well.
No, he's been caught again. He showed incredible...
And Darren is a great referee, he's looking close, and he's stopped the fight. Darren has stopped the fight. And to be honest with you, I think that was a very good stoppage by Darren.
I think it was a very good stoppage. Aaron's very, very brave, but he was taking too many shots, and he looked hurt. His legs looked very unsteady for most of the round, and you just got that feeling that Van Pooch kind of set out in that third round to kind of put the pressure on, and he obviously got the result he was looking for.
Now, the replay you're seeing at the minute isn't actually from this fight, but we will try and get you a replay of the actual knockout a bit later on. But that was some devastating shots there from Van Pooch.
Yeah, I mean, we knew from the start it was a difficult kind of matchup, and we knew that Aaron kind of was he was in a real fight from the first.
You know, it was hooks that done it, wasn't it? It was the hooks, the short hooks on the inside.
And I think that's what we kind of identified in the fight. We've already needed to keep it long and jab and not get into the range where you're going to get caught with hooks.
Yeah, and we did say it was a dangerous one, didn't we? As soon as we seen he was fighting Pucci and not... Eric Nikwando. Yeah, we knew it was going to be a dangerous one, but I really do feel for Aaron. I hope he's okay, and he looks deflated, and I just hope he's okay after that.
Come here, we can jump in.
Okay, we are here with the winner, Louis Van Pooch. Got Nat Lewis with us as well. Louis,
hi,
yeah, you all right?
I won't snog you like Ryan does.
Well, you can do that if you want. Louis, you know, you come in there as the away fighter, but you've really done the business there, and you let off some massive hooks and shots there. Talk us through the fight.
I just sort of started as I normally do, just to have a look at him, see what he's about. He had a nice stiff jab, so...
My excellent corner work, actually.
Yeah, that's what it was.
That's what it
exactly.
was.
I'll leave it there, really. No, he had a nice stiff jab, but sort of to do what I normally do is keep the pressure on with the feet, sort of see what they've got, and then when I start catching them as I come on, I caught him and hurt him. I saw I hurt him, so I thought, it's biding my time. And went in for the kill, they say.
Well, you weren't biding your time that much, but, you know, you did tell him to just get back on it then, Nat.
Telling you what I told him. It's like, use your left hook.
The only thing is, you might not get a fight next week, Pucci, now.
No, it is what it is. hopefully I'm going to Vegas in a few months, so I need the money.
Fair play.
So yeah.
Well, listen, fair play to you, man. You know, you put in your apprenticeship in boxing, you fought everyone, you fight all comers, and you always put on a great show, and you got your win tonight. Commiserations to Aaron, but congratulations to you, mate. Any final words?
Not really for myself, but
Viva
Las Vegas, and obviously thanks to Natalie for coming down. Aww. We did this for a man, all of us.
Yeah,
today.
Absolutely.
We did it for him.
And the entire show is dedicated to the memory of the great man himself, Oliver Harrison.
I'm happy with that.
Rest in peace, buddy.
Thanks for joining us.
Thanks very
Cheers.
Much.